not true. Say it's just a story.
So, did you hear the story of the Johnston twins? As like each other as two new pins. Of one womb born on the self same day. How one was kept and one given away.
And did you never hear how the Johnstons died, never knowing that they shared one name? Till the day they died when a mother cried, "My own dear sons lie slain." And did you never hear of a mother so cruel? There's a stone in place of a heart.
Then bring her on, and come, judge for yourselves how she came to play this part.
Once I had an husband, you know, the sort of chap. I met him at a dance, and how he came on with a chat. He said me eyes were deep blue pools, my skin as soft as snow.
Lovely.
He told me I was sexier than Marilyn Monroe. And we went dancing. We went dancing. Then of course I found that I was 6 weeks overdue.
What?
We got married at the registry, and then we had a do. All had curly salmon sandwiches, and how the ale did flow.
Cheers.
The bride, they said, was lovelier than Marilyn Monroe. And we went dancing. We went dancing. Then the baby came along. We called him
Darren Wayne.
Then 3 months on, I found that I was in the club. Again.
I married a bleeding rabbit.
And though I still fancy dancing, me husband wouldn't go.
Get lost.
The wife, he said, was twice the size of Marilyn Monroe. No more dancing. No more dancing. By the time that I was 25, I looked like 42, with 7 hungry mouths to feed, and one more nearly due. Me husband, he'd walked out on me a month or two ago.
So long.
For the girl, they say, who looks a bit like Marilyn Monroe. They go dancing. They go dancing. Yes, they go dancing. They go.
Listen, love, I've had it up to here with your hard luck stories. You owe me £3.17 and a 4 pence, and now that you pay up like now, and I'll be forced to cut off your delivery.
I said, look, next week I'll pay you.
Next week? Next week never arrives around here. I'd be a rich man if next week ever came.
But look, I start a job next week. We'll have money coming in, and I'll be able to pay you. You can't stop the milk. I need the milk. I'm pregnant.
Listen, love, I may be a milkman, but it's got nothing to do with me. Now, you heard me. No money, no milk.
Ma'am, the baby's crying. He wants his bottle. Where's the milk?
Hey, ma'am, how come I'm on free dinners? All the other kids laugh at me.
Hey, mother, I'm starving and there's nothing in. There never bloody well is.
Don't swear, I've told you.
I can't sleep. I'm hungry. I'm starving.
And me, ma'am.
And me.
Ma'am.
Me.
Oh, it's hard on all you kids, but try and get some sleep. Next week I'll be earning, we'll have loads of things to eat. We'll have ham and jam and spam and
and a roast beef, Yorkshire pudding, a Bedford cake, chicken and chips,
I love that
corned
one.
Beef, sausages, oh, treacle tart, mince and sports, and milkshake mix for the baby. When I bring home the dough, we live like kings, like bright young things, like Marilyn Monroe. It's so great, thank you. It's such a lovely house, it's a pleasure to clean it.
It's a pretty house, isn't it? It's a pity it's so big, I'm finding it rather large at present.
Ah, yeah, with Mr. Lyons being away in that. When does he come back, Mrs. Lyons?
Oh, it seems such a long time. The company sent him out there for 9 months, so what's that? He'll be back in about 5 months' time.
You'll be glad when he's back, won't you? The house won't feel so empty then, will it?
Actually, Mrs. J, we bought such a large house for the children. We thought children might come along.
Well, you might still be able to...
No, I'm afraid. We've been trying for such a long time now, and Mr. Lyons is, well, he says he wanted his own son, not somebody else's. Myself, I believe an adopted child can become one's own.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Hey, it's weird, though, isn't it? He is, you can have kids, and me, I can't stop having them. My husband used to say that all we had to do was shake hands and I'd be in the club. He must have shook hands with me before he left. I'm having another one, you know.
Oh, I see.
Oh, but look, look, it's all right, Mrs. Lyons. I'll still be able to do me work. Having babies, it's like clockwork to me. I'm back on my feet and working the next day, you know. If I have this one at the weekend, I won't even need to take a day off. I just love this job, you know. We can manage to get by now. Jesus Christ, Mrs. Lyons, what are you trying to do?
Michael, what's wrong?
The shoes, the shoes.
Martin?
New shoes on the table. Take them off. Oh, God, Mrs. Lyons, you never put new shoes on the table. You never know what'll happen.
You mean you're superstitious?
No, but you never put new shoes on the table.
Oh, go on with you. Look, if it will make you any happier, I'll put them away.
There's shoes upon the table, and a joker in the pack. The salt's been spilled, and a looking glass cracked. There's one lone magpie overhead.
I'm not superstitious,
the mother said.
I'm not superstitious,
the mother said.
What are you doing here? The milk bill's not due till Thursday.
Well, actually, I've given up the milk round and gone into medicine. I'm your gynecologist. Come on, let's have a listen to the baby's ticker.
I was dead worried about having another one, you know, doctor. I didn't see how we were going to manage with another mouth to feed, but now that I've got me a little job, we'll be okay. We can just scrape by, even with another mouth to feed.
Mouths, Miss Johnston.
What?
Plural. You're going to have twins. Congratulations! And the next one, nurse.
Hello, Mrs. J. How are you? Mrs. J. Anything wrong?
I had it all worked out.
What's the matter?
We were just getting straight.
Why don't you sit down?
With one more mouth to feed, we could have managed, but not with two. The welfare have already been on to me. They say I'm incapable of controlling the kids I've already got. They say I should put some of them into care. But I won't. I love them. I love the bones of every one of them. I'll even love these two when they come along, but like they say at the welfare, kids can't live on love alone.
Twins. You're expecting twins.
How quickly an idea planted can take root and grow into a plan.
The
thought conceived in this very room, grow as surely as a seed in a mother's womb. Give one to me.
What? Give one of them to me?
Give one to you?
Yes. Oh, yes.
But you can't
when
just...
When are you due?
Well, about...
Quickly, tell me. When are you due, Mrs. Johnston?
July, said. The beginning of...
July? And my husband doesn't get back until the middle of July. He need never guess.
Oh, it's mad.
I know it is. It's mad, but it's wonderful. It's perfect. Look, you're what? 4 months pregnant and only just beginning to show? So I'm 4 months pregnant and I'm only just beginning to show. Look. I could have gotten pregnant just before he went away, but I didn't want to tell him in case I miscarried. I didn't want to worry him whilst he was away, but I'll tell him we were wrong. The doctors were wrong. We will have a baby. Our baby, it will work, it will. If only you'll just...
Oh, but Mrs. Lyons, you can't be serious.
You said so yourself. You said you had too many children already.
Yeah, but I don't know if I want to give one of them away.
Already the welfare people are on to you. Mrs. Johnston, with 2 more children, how can you possibly avoid some of them being put into care? Surely, Mrs. Johnston, surely it's better to give one of them to me. At least you could see him every day as he came to work. Oh, please, Mrs. Johnston. Please.
Are you... Are you that desperate to have a baby?
Oh. Each day I look out from this window. I see him with his friends. I hear him call. I rush out. Ever there at home. I've dreamed of all the places I would take him, the games we play, the stories I would tell, the jokes we'd share, the clothing I would make him. I reach out, but as I do,
supplied by George Henry Lee.
He'd have all his own toys and a garden to play in.
Wouldn't make too much noise without the neighbors complaining.
Silver trays to take meals on.
A bike with both wheels on.
Yes. And he'd sleep every night in a bed of his own.
He wouldn't get into fights. He'd leave matches alone. Wouldn't you?
I'd keep him warm in the winter and cool when it shined. I'd pull out his splinters without making him cry. I'd always be there if his dream became a nightmare.
Oh,
this so much, I'll have to... We'll do this properly so that it's thoroughly convincing. I'll need to see you walk and baby clothes. I'll have to knit and buy bottles and suffer from piles.
What?
Doesn't one get piles when one's pregnant? And buy a cot and... Oh, help me, Mrs. J. Is it in the right place? I want it to look right before I go shopping.
What are you going to the shops for? I do the shopping.
Oh, no. From now on, I do the shopping. I want everyone to know about my baby. Mrs. J. We must make this a binding agreement.
In the name of Jesus, the thing was done. Now there is no going back for anyone. It's too late now for feeling torn. There's a pact been sealed. There's a deal been born.
Why do we have to do that?
Mrs. J, nobody must ever know. Therefore, we have to have an agreement. Right. I shan't be long. Goodbye.
How swiftly those who've made a pact can come to overlook the fact, for which the reckoning be delayed. But a debt is a debt and must be paid.
I'm sorry, love. The kid said you were at the hospital. they're lovely, aren't they? I'm sorry, love, especially at a time like this. But you're 12 weeks behind in your payments. I've got to do this, girl.
You shouldn't sign for the bloody stuff, missus. If you know you can't pay, you shouldn't bloody well sign.
Look, if you could give me a couple of weeks' money on this... I could leave it.
You shouldn't have signed for all that stuff, should you? You knew you wouldn't be able to pay, didn't you?
When I got my job, I thought I would be able to pay. When I went into the showroom, I only meant to come out with a couple of things, but when you stand there, it all looks so nice. When you look in the catalog and there's 6 months to pay, it seems years away, and you need a couple of things, so you sign.
Yeah? Well, you bloody well shouldn't.
I know I shouldn't, you soft get! I spent my whole bleeding life knowing I shouldn't. But I do. Now take your son Wireless and get off.
Honest loaf, I'm sorry.
It's all right, lass. We're used to it. We were in the middle of our tea one night when they came for the table.
Ah, well, as long as you can laugh about it, eh? That's the main thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Only mine until the time comes around to pay the bill. Then I'm afraid what can't be paid must be returned. You never ever learn that nothing's yours. Easy terms. Only for a time I must not learn to call you mine. Familiarize that face, those eyes. Make future plans that cannot confirmed on borrowed time, on easy terms. Living on
to recognize your name. You can be sure what's done before will be concealed. Your friends will never learn that once we were crazy twins.
Ma'am, in heaven.
Oh, it's lovely, son. He'll be well looked after there. He'll have anything he wants.
We have his own bike?
Yeah, with both wheels on.
Why can't I have my own bike, huh?
I'll take a look in the catalogue next week and we'll see what the bags are like in there. Look, I've told you, when I get home, I've got to go to work. He's really coming on now, isn't he, Mr. Lyons? I'll bet you're dead proud of him, aren't you, eh?
Yes, I am. Aren't I, Edward? I'm proud of Jennifer, too.
Ah, oh, he's lovely. Oh, look, he wants to be picked up.
No, Mrs. Johnston, he's fine. He doesn't want to be picked up.
Ah, oh, but look, he's gonna cry.
If he needs picking up, I shall pick him up, all right?
I'm sorry, I just thought...
Yes, well, has the bathroom been done? Time is getting on.
Yeah.
Don't be hard on the woman. She only wanted to hold the baby. All women like to hold babies, don't they?
But I don't want her to hold the baby, Richard. I don't want the baby to catch anything. Babies catch things very easily, Richard.
All right. You know best.
You don't see her as much as I do. She's always fussing over him. Any opportunity, and she's cooing and cuddling as if she were his mother. She's always bothering him, Richard. Always. Ever since the baby arrived, she ignores most of her work.
Come on. It's all right, Jennifer. You're just a little... It's this depression thing that happens after a woman's had a...
Oh, I'm not depressed, Richard. It's just that she makes me feel... Richard, I think she should go.
And what will you do for help in the house?
I'll find somebody who doesn't spend all day fussing over the baby.
I suppose you know best. The house is your domain. Look, Jen, I've got a board meeting. I really must dash, okay?
Richard, could you let me have some cash?
Of course.
I need about...
£50.
My God, what for?
I've got a lot of things to buy for the baby. I've got the nursery to sort out.
All right. Here.
Thank you. Mrs. Johnston, would you come out here for a moment, please?
Yes?
Sit down. Richard and I have been talking it over, and, well, the thing is, we both think it would be better if you left.
Left where?
It's your work. Your work has deteriorated.
But I work the way I've always worked.
Well, I'm sorry we're not satisfied.
But what will I do? How are we going to manage without my job?
Yes, we've thought of that. It's a lot of money, but...
Okay. All right, Mrs. Lyons, right. If I'm gone, I'm taking my son with me. I'm going to take
him. No, you're not. Edward is my son, mine.
I'll tell someone. I'll bring the police in.
You'll tell nobody. You gave your baby away. Don't you realize what a crime that is? You'll be locked up. You sold your baby.
I didn't. You told me. You said I could see him every day. Well, I'm going to tell someone. I'm going to tell them.
You'll tell nobody. Because you know it will happen, don't you? You know what they say about twins secretly parted, don't you?
What?
They say that if either twin learns that he was once one of a pair, they shall both immediately die. It means, Mrs. Johnston, that these brothers shall grow up unaware of the other's existence. They shall be raised apart and never, ever told of what was once the truth. You won't tell anyone about this, Mrs. Johnston, because if you do, you will kill them!
Shoes upon the table, and the spider's been killed. Someone broke the looking glass. There's a full moon shining, and the salt's been spilled. You're walking on the pavement cracks. Don't you know what's gonna come to pass? Now you know the devil's like your number. You know he's gonna find ya. You know he's right behind ya. He's staring through your windows, he's creeping down the hall. There ain't no point in clutching at your rosary. You're always gonna know what was done. Even when you shut your eyes, you still see that you sold a son, and you can't tell anyone. Now you know the devil's got your number. You know he's gonna find ya. You know he's right behind ya. He's staring through your windows, he's creeping down the hall. Yes, you know the devil's got your number. You know he's gonna find ya. You know he's right behind ya. He's standing on your step and he's knocking at your door. He's knocking at your door. He's knocking at your door.
Go away!
Mother, we opened the bleeding door or what?
Mickey?
Why is the door bolted, Mum? Do you think it was the rent man? Ma'am, last time he's robbed me of the gun, and that was me bestest one. Why does he always rob all me things off me?
Because you're the youngest, Mickey. It used to happen to our Sammy when he was the youngest.
Oh, ma'am, we were playing mounted police and Indians, and I'm a Mountie. This morning we've killed over 3,000 Indians.
Good.
Ma'am, you're dead.
Mm-hmm.
What's up, ma'am?
Nothing, son. Go on, you go out and play, but don't go playing with those hooligans down at the rough end.
No, we're at the other end, near the big houses in the park.
Mickey, come here. What did you say? Where have you been playing?
I'm sorry, Mum, I forgot.
What have I told you about playing up near there? Come here.
It wasn't my fault, honest.
So whose fault was it then?
The Indians. They were riding up there. They were trying to escape.
Don't you ever go up near there, do you hear me?
Here, you let our Sammy go up there.
Our Sammy's older than you.
But why?
Just shut up. Never mind why. You don't go up near there. Now go on, you go and play, but stay outside the front door where I can see you.
For men, the Indians.
Go on!
Before, where? You were playing with some other boys. Near my house.
Do you live up by the park?
Yes. Are you going to come up and play there again?
No, I would do, but I'm not allowed.
Why?
Cause me mem says.
Well, my mummy doesn't allow me to play down here, actually.
Jesus, sweet.
All right.
What?
Here.
Can I have another one? For us, Sammy?
Yes, of course. Take as many as you want.
Are you soft?
I don't think so.
Round here, if you ask for a sweet, you have to ask about 20 million times, and you know what?
What?
They still don't breed and give you one. Sometimes our Sammy does, but you have to be dead careful if our Sammy gives you a sweet.
Why?
Because if our Sammy gives you a sweet, it's usually because he's weed on it first.
That sounds like super fun.
It is, if you're our Sammy.
Do you want to come and play?
I might do, but I'm not playing now because I'm pissed off.
Pissed off? You say the most smashing things, don't you? Do you know any more words like that?
Yeah, I know loads of words like that. Like the F word.
Pardon?
The F word.
What does it mean?
I don't know. It sounds good, though, doesn't it?
Fantastic. When I get home, I'll look it up in the dictionary.
In the what?
The dictionary. Don't you know what a dictionary is?
Of course I do. It's a thingy, isn't it?
A book which explains the meaning of words.
The meaning of words. Yeah. Our Samuel'll be here soon. I hope he's in a good mood. He's dead mean sometimes.
Why?
It's because he's got a plate in his head.
A plate? In his head.
Yeah. When my mum was at work, our Donna Marie was supposed to be looking after him, but he fell out that window and broke his head open. So they rushed him to the hospital, put a plate in his head.
A plate? A dinner plate?
Our Sammy's head's not really that big. I think it was one of the little plates you have bread off.
A side plate?
No, it's on the top.
And you can see the shape of it in his head.
I suppose, yeah, if you looked under his hair.
You know the most smashing things. Will you be my best friend?
Yeah, if you want.
What's your name?
Michael Johnson, but everyone calls me Mickey. What's yours?
Edward Lyons.
Do they call you Eddie?
No.
Well, I will.
Will you?
Yeah, how old are you, Eddie?
7.
I'm older than you, I'm nearly 8.
Well, I'm nearly 8, really.
When's your birthday?
July the 18th.
So is mine.
Is it really?
Aye. We were born on the same day. That means we can become blood brothers. Do you want to be blood brother, Eddie?
Yes, please.
It hurts, you know.
Ow.
Now give us yours. See, this means that we're blood brothers, and we always have to stand by each other. So you repeat after me. I will always defend me brother.
I will always defend me brother.
And stand by him.
And stand by him.
And share all my sweets with him.
And share all my sweets.
Hurry!
Hiya, Sammy.
Give us a sweet.
I haven't got none.
Yes, you have. Yes, Sawyer gave you one for Sammy, remember?
You little robbing cat!
No, I'm not. And anyway, you robbed me best disc gun.
It's lost anyway. It only fires caps. I'm gonna get a real gun soon. I'm gonna get an air gun. Pew! And what are you looking at?
Pardon? That's Eddie. He lives up by the park.
He's a friggin' posse.
No, he's not. He's my best friend.
You're just soft. You're just soft little kids.
Where are you going?
I've got to do another burial. Me worms have died again.
Oh, are you coming to the burial? Oh, Sammy's having a burial. Can we come, Sammy?
Look, they was alive and wriggling this morning, but by dinner time they was dead.
Mickey! Mickey!
Is that your mummy? Ma'am, this is me brother.
What?
Me blood brother, Eddie.
Eddie, who?
Edward Lyons, Mrs. Johnston. Eddie's my best friend, ma'am. He lives up by the park and...
Mickey, get in the house.
What?
Sammy, you and all, both of you, get in.
But I'm older than him. I don't have to.
I said get the peria.
But I haven't done nothing. I'll see you, Eddie.
Sammy!
I'll get you.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Johnston. Have I done something wrong?
Does your mother know that you're down here? And what would you say if she did know?
I think she'd be angry.
So don't you think you better get home before she finds out?
Yes.
Go on then.
Would it be all right if I came to play with Mickey on another day? Or perhaps he could come to play at my house.
Don't you ever come around here again. Ever.
But I just want to...
Ever! Now go on. Beat it. Go home before the bogeyman gets you.
Should we meet again? I will not recognize your name. You can be sure what's done before will be concealed. Your friends will never learn that one.
Well, Edward, I've got to go to work for an hour.
Richard, you didn't say...
Oh, darling, I'm sorry, but if we complete this merger, I will have more time, I promise you. That's why we're doing it, Jen. If we complete this, the firm will run itself, and I'll have plenty of time to spend with you both.
It's not me, it's Edward. You should spend more time with him. I don't want him growing away from you.
Daddy, how do you spell bogeyman?
Ask Mummy. Darling, I'll see you later now. Must dash.
Mummy, how do you spell bogeyman? Bogeyman.
Edward, wherever did you hear such a thing?
I'm trying to look it up.
There's no such thing as the bogeyman. It's a superstition. The sort of thing a silly mother might say to her children. The bogeyman will get you.
Will he get me?
Edward... I've already told you there's no such thing.
Does Eddie live here?
Pardon?
Is he coming out to play? Mickey!
I got out Sammy's catapult. Are you coming out?
Oh, isn't Mickey fantastic, Mom?
Do you go to the same school as Edward?
No.
Oh.
We're blood brothers, aren't we, Mickey?
Yeah, we were born on the same day.
Come on, let's go.
Edward, it's time for bed.
Mummy, it's not.
I'm very sorry, but it's Edward's bedtime.
Mummy, it's early.
Edward, where did you meet that boy?
At his house.
And his second name is Johnston, isn't it?
Yes, and I think you're very, very mean.
I've told you never to go near where boys like that live.
But why?
Because you're not like him. You're not. Do you understand?
No, I don't understand. And I hate you.
Edward, don't say that. Don't ever say that. What I'm doing, it's only for your own good.
It's only because I love you.
You don't, you don't. If you loved me, you'd let me go out and play with Mickey because he's my best friend. I like him more than you.
Edward, Edward, don't say that. Don't ever say that.
Well, it's true. And I will say it. And I know what you can do.
What? What?
You... you can piss off.
You see? You see why I don't want you mixing with filth like that? You learn filth from him and behave like a horrible little boy. But you are not like them. You are not. You are my son, mine, and you won't ever. Oh, my son. My beautiful, beautiful son.
If we don't.
Oh, tell me, Mother, why all her stickies always disappear when you're in our house?
What?
End the half clowns!
Gang, we don't want to play with these ones. They're just kids.
Care about our Sammy anyway. Look!
Oh, careful, Mickey! Are you okay?
He thinks no one knows he's got it, but I know where he hides it.
Oh, just a go!
No, let's go get Eddie first.
Who?
Come on, I'll show you.
Okay.
Eddie, are you coming out?
Me mom says I haven't got to play with you.
Well, my mom says I haven't got to play with you. But take no notice of mothers. They're soft. Come on, I've got Linda with me. She's a girl, but she's all right. Hiya.
Hi, Mick. Hello, Linda.
Hello, Eddie. Look, we've got Sammy's air gun.
You can have a shot at our target in the park.
Peter Pan.
We always shoot at that, don't we, Linda?
Yeah, and we try and shoot his little thingy off, don't we, Mickey? Come on, gang, let's go.
But, Mickey, suppose we get caught by a policeman.
Take no notice. We've been caught loads of times by a policeman, haven't we, Linda?
Yeah, oh, my God, hundreds of times. More than that.
We say dead funny things to him, too, don't we, Linda?
What sorts of funny things?
All sorts, don't we, Mickey?
like you know when they ask what your name is? We always say something like Adolf Hitler.
Yeah, and, hey, Eddie, you know when they say, what do you think you're doing? We always say something like waiting for the 92 bus.
Do you really? Goodness, that's fantastic.
Come on.
Edward?
There's gypsies in the wood and they've been watching you. They're gonna take your baby away. There's gypsies in the wood and they've been calling you. Can Edward please come out to play? Please can he come with us and play? Now you know the devil's got your number. You know he's gonna find you. You know he's right behind you. He's staring through the window. He's creeping down the hall.
Richard, oh... Richard.
For God's sake, Jennifer, I told you on the phone. He'll just be out playing somewhere.
But where?
Outside somewhere, with friends.
I don't want him out playing.
Jennifer, he's not a baby.
I don't care.
For Christ's sake! You bring me home from work in the middle of the day just to say you haven't seen him for an hour? Perhaps we should be talking about you getting something for your nerves.
There's nothing wrong with my nerves. It's this place. I hate it. Richard, I don't want to stay here anymore. I want to move.
Oh, Jennifer, how many times? The factory is here. My work is here.
It doesn't have to be somewhere far away, but we have got to move. Because if we stay here, I feel that something terrible will happen. something bad.
Look, Jen, what is this thing you keep talking about getting away from?
Hmm? It's these people that Edward has started mixing with. Can't you see how he's drawn to them? They're drawing him away from me.
Oh, Christ! I do really think you should see a doctor.
I don't need to see a doctor. I just need to move away from this place because I'm frightened. I'm frightened for Edward.
Frightened of what, woman?
I'm frightened...
Shoes upon the table, and a spider's been killed. Someone broke the looking glass. There's a full moon shining, and the saucepan's spilled. You're walking on the pavement tracks. Don't know what's gonna come to pass. Now you know the devil's got your number. You know he's gonna find you. You know he's right behind you. He's staring through your windows, he's creeping.
Playing with the gun no more.
Why?
It gets broke if you use it too much.
What are we going to do now, Mickey?
I don't know.
I do.
What?
Let's throw some stones through them windows.
Oh, I dare you, Linda. I dare you.
I will.
Well, I will. I'm not scared either. Are you Eddie?
Well...
He is. Look, Eddie's scared.
No, he's not. Are you Eddie?
No, I'm not. I'm not scared at all, actually.
Right. When I count to three, we all throw together. One, two, three.
Me mother caught a flea. She put it in a teapot to make a cup of tea. And what do you think you're doing?
Waiting for the 92 bus.
Oh, he's not with us.
No, he's definitely with us. What's your name, son?
Adolf Hitler.
Ma'am.
And he was about to commit a serious crime, love. Do you understand that? You don't want to end up in court again, do you? Well, that's what's going to happen if I have any more trouble for one of yours. I warned you last time, didn't I, Miss Johnston? About your Sammy? Well, there'll be no more bloody warnings from now on. Either you keep him in order, Mrs., or be the courts for you. Or worse... Won't it? Yes, it will.
Maybe someday we'll move away and start all over again in some new place where they don't know my face and nobody's heard. Begin again, feel we can win, and then
as I say, it was more of a prank, really, Mr. Lyons. I just stock his pocket money for you. But one thing I would say, if you don't mind me saying, is I'm not sure I'd let him mix with the likes of them in the future. Make sure he keeps with his own kind, Mr. Lyons. Well, thanks for the drink, sir. All the best now. He's a good lad, aren't you, Adolf? Good night, sir.
Edward, how would you like to move to another house?
Why, Daddy?
Well, various reasons, really. Actually, Mommy's not been too well lately, and we thought to move perhaps somewhere further out to the country might Do you think you'd like that?
I want to stay here.
Well, you think about it, old chap.
Hello, Mrs. Johnston. How are you?
You what?
I'm sorry. Is something wrong?
No, I don't usually have kids inquiring about me, Elf. I'm all right, and how are you, Master Lyons?
Very well, thank you.
You look it. You look very well. Does your mother look after you?
Yes, of course.
Now, listen, Eddie, I told you not to come around her again.
I'm sorry, I just wanted to see Mickey.
I know, but it's best if...
Well, it won't matter. We're moving away. To the country.
I'll look at you.
But I'd much rather live here.
Would you? When are you going?
Tomorrow.
So, we really won't see you again, eh? Oh, what's up?
I don't want to go. I want to stay here, where my friends are, where Mickey is.
Now listen, don't you be soft. You'll probably love it in your new house. You'll meet lots of new friends, and in no time at all, you'll forget Mickey ever existed.
I won't. I'll never forget.
Now listen, here's you wanting to stay, and here's me. I've been trying to get out for years. We're a right pair, aren't we, you and me?
And why don't you, Mrs. Johnston, buy a house near us?
Just like that?
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
Would you like a picture of Mickey to take with you, so you could remember him?
Yes, please.
See, look, there's Mickey there. He was just a young kid when that was taken.
And is that you, Mrs. Johnston? Can I really have this?
Yeah, but keep it our secret, eh, Eddie? Just our secret between you and me.
All right, Mrs. Johnston.
What are you looking at?
I thought you weren't very nice. I thought you didn't like me. But I think you're smashing.
God help the girls when you start dancing.
Pardon?
Nothing. Mickey! Say goodbye to Eddie. He's moving.
Like it here?
Yes, it's very nice.
Oh, Edward, look! Look at the cows and the trees. Oh, Edward, you're going to like it here so much, aren't you?
Are you feeling all right, Mommy?
Much better, darling. Oh, Edward!
Don't look. That's a magpie. Never look at one magpie. It's one for sorrow.
Edward, that's just a stupid superstition.
It's not. Mickey told me.
Edward, I think we can forget all about the silly things that Mickey said.
I'm going inside. I want to read.
Children take time to adapt to new surroundings. He'll be as right as rain in a few days. He won't even remember he once lived somewhere else.
Is Eddie in?
Eddie? I'm afraid Eddie doesn't live here now.
Oh, yeah.
Goodbye.
Do you know where he lives now?
Pardon?
See, I've got some money. I was going to go on the bus and see him.
I'm afraid I've no idea.
It's somewhere in the country, isn't it?
I honestly don't know, and I'm rather busy. Goodbye.
Kids out on the streets today. You could be living on the moon. Maybe everybody's packed their bags and moved away. Gonna be a long, long, long Sunday afternoon. Just killing time and kicking cans around. Try to remember jokes I knew. I tell them to myself, but they're not funny since I found. It's gonna be a long, long, long Sunday afternoon. My best friend always had sweets to share. He knew every word in the dictionary. He was clean, neat, and tidy from Monday to Friday. I wish that I could be like working clothes, talk properly, like do sums in history, like my friend. My friend.
My best friend, he could swear like a soldier. You'd laugh till you died at the stories he told you. He was untidy from Monday to Friday. I wish that I could be like, kick a ball and climb a tree like, run around with dirty knees like my friend. My friend.
Feels like everybody stayed in bed. Or maybe I woke up too soon. Am I the last survivor? Is everybody dead, but dead, but dead, but dead, dead? On this long, long, long Sunday afternoon, Sunday afternoon.
Oh, bright new day, we're moving away.
What's that, man?
We're starting all over again.
Can I swim in tomorrow, man?
Oh, bright new day, going away. Where nobody's heard of our name.
I never wrote nothing, honest, man.
Where we can begin again, feel we can't.
in a new destination, and no reputation is following me.
What is it?
We're getting out, we're moving the house.
Wow.
We're starting all over again. We're leaving this mess for our new address. 65 Scamas LA.
Same country.
The air is so pure, you get drunk just by breathing. The washing stays clean on the line. Where there's space for the kids, cause the garden's so big, it would take you a week just to reach a far side. Come on, Sammy, Mickey, now you've all got help. I'm going to just excuse us, we've got a pack, we're moving away.
What did you say?
We're moving away. Praise the Lord, he has delivered us at last. Predict the sharp drop in the crime rate.
It'll be calm and peaceful around here.
And now I might even get paid what is my name.
And you'll see crime PC will soon disappear.
Pack the bags, we're leaving the rags. The wobbly water chest doors are never closed. The two-legged chair, the carpet's so bare. You wouldn't see it if it wasn't for the holes. Just wash our hands of this blot. But it's no longer fitting for me to be sitting on a sofa. I know for a fact was knocked off.
Big me!
I get a car beyond London and go driving out to the sands.
You move it too, Mickey!
And at the weekend, a gentleman friend would take me dance to the local bands. We'll have a front room, and then if it should happen, His Holiness flies. He can sit there with me, eating toast, drinking tea, in the sort of surroundings that remind him of home.
It's like the country, isn't it, man?
There will be all right, I hear, son, away from the muck and the dirt and the bloody trouble. Air could dance, come here.
Get off.
Oh, brand new day, we're moving away. We're starting.
I'm smiling. I haven't seen you happy like this for ages.
I'm happy now, son. Oh, Jesus, where's the others?
They went to that field then.
Sammy, get off that bleeding cow. Linda, get over here. Your mother would kill you. Oh, Jesus, what's a Donna Marie stepped into?